فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
That's what حافظ بن أخذ أخرى مثال. That's why عراقي سنة ألفية وات ورد لكن قال يحيى البر لم يفت الخمسات إلا النزر وفيه ما فيه لقول الجعفي أحفظ من عشر ألف ألفي. That is the first view, which is حافظ ابن الأخرم. حافظ ابن الأخرم got refuted by who? إمام النووي. الإمام النووي رحمه الله refuted him. And that speech is wrong. That a lot of things did. They did miss out a lot of things. They did miss out a lot of things. A lot of ahadith were authentic. So what is absent from their books are more in number. The more authentic books that are, the more authentic ahadith which are missing from their book is more. Huh? And what they have in their book which is authentic is little in comparison to what was out there. Because Imam al-Bukhari himself, he himself said, وَمَا تَرَكْتُ مِنَ الصِّحَاحِ أَكْثَرُ. He himself said that, Bukhari. What I have left out behind from the ahadith which was sahih are more. In another place, what did he say? He said, أَحْفَظُ مِئَةَ أَلْفَ حَدِيثِ. He said, I have memorized 100,000 ahadiths. وَمِئَةِ أَلْفَ حَدِيثٍ غَيْرَ الصَّحِيحِ. And I've also memorized 200,000 ahadiths which are not sahih. So 100,000 ahadith, Bukhari said, I memorized which are sahih. You see? Now it leaves us with what? If Bukhari is saying, I, rahimahullah, is saying, I have memorized 100,000 ahadith which are sahih, then the question that comes is that, how many ahadith are in his sahih? And how many ahadith which were, and how many ahadith are the ahadith which are in Muslim? How many ahadith which are in Muslim, and how many Bukhari, and then how many ahadith are in Muslim? Bukhari, rahimahullah, jumlatu ma fihi, the general figure that is in his book is 7,000 ومئتان وخمسة وسبعون حديثا 7,275 أحاديث, and that counting is with the repetitive ones that come back. If we take off the ones that are repeating itself, and we say the actual ahadith without it repeated is 4,000. Only 4,000 ahadith which are there. Number two is Imam Muslim. Imam Muslim, rahimahullah, how many did he narrate? He narrated 12,000. This is bil-mukarrarati. This is where the repetition of the ahadith repeating itself. If we take off the repetition, how many hadith does he have? He also has 4,000. There's roughly 4,000 as well. The question now is if the hadith which are in Bukhari and Muslim, there are more hadith which are outside it, that are missing, that are absent, then the question is, where can one find those hadith? No doubt he can go to Sahih ibn Khuzaymah, he can go to Sahih ibn Hibban, he can go to Mustadrak al-Hakim al-Naysaburi. He can go to Sunan al-Arba'a, meaning the four Sunans, Abu Dawud, Tirmidhi, Ibn Majah, Nasa'i. He can go to Sunan al-Dharqutni. He can go to Sunan al-Bayhaqi. And other than them, whereas those books, by the way, those books, we will come regarding them, how they are in after Bukhari, the sequence that they're in terms of authenticity. But you have to remember any ahadith which are not in Bukhari and Muslim, and some other ones which we're going to mention later, they have to mention the authentication of hadith. Abu Dawud, a hadith that's in it, Imam Abu Dawud Sijistani, rahimahullah, a hadith that's in his Sunan, you can't say Abu Dawud narrated, so it's authentic. No, it's not. Even he himself, Bukhari, a hadith he narrated in other books of his, not in his Sahih, it can be rejected, it can be authentic, and it can be weak. Such as the hadith he narrated in his Kitab Adab al-Mufrad. Don't say, oh, this is Bukhari, rahimahullah ta'ala. You see? Because he did not condition authenticity in Adab al-Mufrad. The same way he has not conditioned authenticity in his kitab, Khalq Af'al al-Ibad. The way he is ajza'. So those books, there has to be a clear-cut proof from you that he authenticated hadith in it. That he authenticated a particular hadith. Or that this, following the science of hadith, that the hadith science is correct. Does that make sense? But we'll speak about that in more details. So the other books, there has to be a tansisu ala sihati. Except the people who condition authenticity in their books. Are you with me? Except the person who conditions authenticity. Abu Dawood did not condition authenticity. Abu Dawood did not condition authenticity. And anyone who reads a risala, there's a letter he wrote, Abu Dawood al-Sijistani, is called Risalatu ila Ahli Makkah. It's called Risalatu ila Ahli Makkah. It was a letter written by Imam Abu Dawood rahimahullah when they asked him about his book, his Sunan, in which he replied about what he wanted and what he meant in this book, and how he works in his book, what he's doing in it. Sah? So pay attention. Whilst we're on that, there's two points I want to really mention, which is the kitab, which is the Mustadrak of Imam al-Hakim al-Nisaburi, as a note, I want to go over it and explain a bit about it. And I want to talk about al-Mustakhraj. What is a Mustakhraj? When we hear this hadith, is a Mustakhraj. It's in the Mustakhraj of Mithlan Abi Bakr al-Ismaili, or it's in the Mustakhraj of Abi Awana al-Sifrayini, or it's in the Mustakhraj of Abu Nu'aym al-Asbahani. Like, what is a mustakhraj? And also, what is a mustadrak? We need to know. I'm specifically going to choose the mustadrak of Imam al-Hakim al-Naysaburi. Imam al-Hakim al-Naysaburi's kitab, his mustadrak, first of all, it's a big, fat, large book. And it's from the books of hadith. It's from the books of hadith. The author of that book, he mentions in that book, hadith which are authentic and they are of the condition of Bukhari and Muslim, or Bukhari alone or Muslim alone. So what he's doing is that he's not just bringing a hadith which are authentic, he's bringing a hadith which are the conditions of Bukhari and Muslim, that Bukhari and Muslim did not bring in their sahih. Are you with me? That Bukhari and Muslim left. He comes and he brings it. He says, these are the men of Bukhari. These are the conditions that Bukhari used to follow. Are you with me? And he will narrate the hadith. And what will he do? He will narrate the hadith, and the people will see that Bukhari left his hadith, but it's his condition. It was condition of Bukhari. This is what he did. But Al-Hakim al-Naysaburi, the man that did that, he's a mutasahil, he's very lean on hadith, he's very mutasahil, very, very lean. So, that book, scholars followed it up to correct him on what he got right and to weaken him where he was wrong and to point it out. And from the scholars that did that was Imam al-Dhahabi, rahimahullah ta'ala. A lot of hadith, the Dhahabi did that. But the book still needs some people to work on it. It requires still some work. That kitab, you find hadith, remember? Rawahu Abu Hakim al-Naysaburi. Imam Abu Hakim, Imam al-Hakim al-Naysaburi narrated it. Wa wafaqahu al-Dhahabi. See, he wa wafaqahu, agreed with him was Dhahabi. You'd find that a lot of the time. You find that, huh? Naam. We will speak about it in details properly when we go to Alfiyat al-Iraqi. The next one is called Al-Mustadrak. Al-Mustakhraj. The second one is called Al-Mustakhraj. Mustakhraj, what does it mean? It means that the author of that book, he comes to a book from the books of hadith. He comes to a book from the books of hadith. Any book of hadith. he will bring out a hadith of his chain. Without the chain of this scholar. So he will go to Bukhari's book. Are you with me? Mathalan. And he will look at Imam al-Bukhari hadith in which he has narrated. Are you with me? This chain is from who? It's from him. He brings it with his chain. He comes to the sheikh. He comes to it. He comes to where? He meets the author of that book to his sheikh. He meets the author of the book through his sheikh. Or the person above the sheikh. So this becomes an additional chain which scholars would then rely on. The scholars that did that is Abu Bakr al-Ismaili, Abi Awana al-Tasfrayini. Abu Bakr al-Ismaili did that to Bukhari. So the first one is Abu Bakr al-Ismaili did that to Bukhari. Abi Awana al-Tasfrayini, he did that to Muslim. Abu Nu'aym al-Asbahani, he did it to both of them. The question now is, are you with me? The Mustakhraj, when he brings the hadith of Bukhari with his own chain, is the wording going to be the same? Is the wording of the Mustakhraj and the wording of, like for example, if you look at the Mustakhraj of Al-Imam Abu Bakr al-Ismaili, who did it to Bukhari, would his wording of the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ be the same wording as Imam al-Bukhari's one? No. There won't be. Necessarily. Because everyone is mentioning that which the hadith that they're narrating from their own shiukhs. So sometimes there might be slight differences in terms of the wordings. There is a question now, which is, if a person narrates a hadith from the mustakhraj, if a person narrates a hadith from the is he allowed and is he permitted to say Bukhari Muslim narrated it? Is he allowed to do that? You're allowed when two conditions are met. The first one is أن يقابل الحديث بروايتهما. You go, first of all, and you look at the hadith and you put it in comparison to the Bukhari and Muslim. Then you're allowed to. The second one is, if the author and the mustakhraj says, he says, I have brought this hadith in the wording of Bukhari and Muslim. Then you attribute it to Bukhari and Muslim if you want. One is that you do it, you do the muqabala yourself. You go and you compare the two. Or the mustakhraj, the Abu Awana mathalan, Abu Bakr al-Ismaili, you know, Abu Nu'aym al-Asbahani, one of them does it, and then you go and you do, you take their word for it, and then you ascribe it to Bukhari or the book, Muslim. What is the benefit of Mustakhraj? Why? What's the benefit? What do we? There's three benefits. First of all, it's ulul isnadi, the chain becoming short. If you go to Tadrib al-Rawi, and Imam al-Suyuti gives 10 benefits. Suyuti gives how many benefits? 10. But the most important one is ulul isnad. The chain of narration being what? Shorter. And getting closer to the Prophet ﷺ. Na'am. The second one, az-ziyadatu fi qadr as-sahih. Increasing in the status of authenticity. The third one is al-quwwatu bi kathrati at-turuq. The hadith becomes strong with the extra additional chains of narration that come to it. It becomes much stronger. There's another question that needs to be asked. The hadith that are narrated in Bukhari and Muslim, do we always say authentic? Are they always authentic? As we've just taken previously, that Bukhari and Muslim, they both have not put in their sahih except that which is authentic. You have to understand that. Every ahadith which are in Bukhari and Muslim are what? They are authentic. And that this ummah, talaqat kitabayhima bil qabuli. This ummah have accepted the book Bukhari and Muslim with like we've respected it, we've accepted it, we've admired it, we've cherished it. The question now is it possible by any chance or form or shape that one finds in Bukhari and Muslim a hadith which he doesn't give or authenticity is not ascribed to it? If the hadith, Bukhari narrated it with a chain of narration. He narrated it with what? Chain of narration. From himself to the Prophet, we will say it is authentic. Are you with me? If anything Bukhari narrates from himself to the Prophet, it's authentic. The same way as Imam Muslim. If Muslim narrates a hadith from himself to who? Are you all with me? From himself to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, both of them are authentic. And ما رواياه, that which both of them have narrated bil isnad al muttasil, from a chain of narration that is connected, that Bukhari narrates from himself to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, فهو المحكوم بصحته, we rule that to be authentic. We rule it to be what? Authentic. Good. As for the ahadith which the من مبدأ السند, that Bukhari drops off his teacher مثلا, or he drops his teacher and other people. Such as what? What does he say? Bukhari says that the Prophet ﷺ said straight away. He's dropped his teacher and he's also dropped other people, correct? This is now given the rule of mu'allaq. This is called what? It's called mu'allaq. And it's regarding what mu'allaq is in details. It will come to us, inshallah, in the kitab, the Nukhbat al-Fiqh that we're in right now. And we've previously taken it in what book? In our Bayquniyah. Now that hadith which is mu'allaq, we're going to deal with it as follows. Keep in mind that the hadith which are mu'allaq are a lot in Bukhari. They're a lot. But they are situated, the places where Bukhari placed those hadith which are mu'allaq, a lot of them are in what? In the headings, the titles, the chapter headings. The chapter headings is where he does it. في تراجم الألباب. He brings أحاديث which are معلقات. Or the introduction of every chapter. He introduces a speech which is معلق. You won't find in Bukhari أحاديث which are في صلب الأبواب. Whilst he's in the bringing the narrations in the middle, he'll just throw in a hadith which is معلق. You won't find that. البتة whatsoever. As for Muslim on the other hand, فَلَيْسَ فِيهِ مِنْ ذَٰلِكَ إِلَّا حَدِيثٌ وَاحِدٌ. Muslim doesn't have a hadith which is mu'allaq except one. And it's in Babu Tayammum. And it's in Babu Tayammum. The question now is, brothers, if those scholars have narrated those hadith, so we said a hadith which are chained are mentioned from himself to who? The Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam is authentic. That is his conditions. That is the hadith he was referring to, that he was saying, I have narrated authentic hadith. The ones he's put inside his chapter headings, or he's placed in the introductions of the starting of a topic. Bukhari does that. Are you all with me? Those are hadith, we deal with it in according to how he narrates it. Pay attention. We look at the form and the way he presents it to us. If he does it in a manner which is بصيغة الجزم, such as if he says, مثلا, قال, أمر, ذكر, فهو حكم بصحتي. This one we give the ruling of authenticity to it. قال, أمر, ذَكَرَ عَنْ. Are you with me? قَالَ أَبَرَ ذَكَرَ عَنْ أَبَرَ. This is called what? It is called, even though it's مُعَلَّق, it's called what? بِسِيغَةِ الْجَزْمِ. What does it take? Authenticity.